Well, another busy year for Fusion IP. This is a company that has contracts with both Cardiff and Sheffield universities, and they support the intellectual property owners as they develop their products and take them to market. The chief executive is David Baynes. Dave, thank you very much indeed for joining us today. Technically, you've got about 23 portfolio companies. How does the model actually work?
Yeah, we do have about that number. The way it works is we technically actually own the intellectual property. I have to caveat that a bit. What we actually have is we have the contractual right to own shares in any company set up to commercialise that intellectual property. So in fact, the IP remains part of the university, but we're free to select any IP we think will be suitable for commercialisation. We can set up a company, have the IP put into it, and we effectively own that entity. And then what we actually always do is we retain 60% for Fusion and give 40% to the academics who are behind the ideas.
And what typically would be the limitations or the rules that you set on yourselves as to what makes an opportunity worth following up?
Yeah, well, we get about 150 disclosures a year over our two universities. Our two universities spend about 100 million a year on research. It's a product about 200 million research we're selecting from. And the criteria we're really looking for out of those 150 disclosures is something which has a very disruptive technology, has to be really different in the marketplace. The technology has to have been patented, so it's secure IP, has to have a big market. It's very easy to get excited about technology, but actually nobody wants it much, so you need a big market. You need to have the academic on side. You never do anything against the academics' wills, so you want them obviously happy to work with you. And finally, you need to be able to conceive a revenue model. It may be 15 years away in the case of drug development, but you need to be able to see how this will generate income for you one day. If you have all five criteria like that, then that is a good candidate for company. And we're doing about 2 to 3 companies out of the 150 disclosures, 2 to 3 become companies a year.
Okay, and as you said, the three spin-offs this year, two from Cardiff, one from Sheffield, Asilis Medical Instruments, Progentech, and Serin Photonics. Is 3 a year about right? Is that the target? How would you measure that?
I think 3 is quite good, actually. It may sound low. We also have rights to licensing, certain licensing rights, certainly particularly at Sheffield. So up at Sheffield, of its 95 disclosures, we probably start 1 or 2 companies, but we probably license 10 other bits of IP. So we're probably mining as hard as you could. We're getting sort of 10% of all disclosures turning into commercial opportunity. And I think you'll find that's well above actually the average for kind of a tech transfer space.
Let's talk about cash. Ugly subject, but we have to. You raised £3 million this year, plus some co-funding for a 19.8 stake in your company with IP Group. What's the cash burn? How does that model work?
Yeah, we do spend money. We have an overhead growth of about 1.7 million, but because of the ability to charge out to the companies that we support, because we're a real incubator type business, it's a net burn of about 800,000 a year is actually what it costs to run the overhead. And then we can invest as we choose. So investments traditionally from ourselves has been between about 1.2 and a maximum of 2 million a year. In the last year, as a guide, we invested about 1.9 million, and then we raised another 7 million for our companies. Raised about 9 million quid for our companies, with a burn overall last year of about 2.8 million, something like that.
Does that mean you need to raise cash again soon?
Well, no, not soon. Following the fundraising we did last year, we still got quite a lot of money. Even now, we've got sort of over £4 million. And at some point, we will anticipate getting exits from these companies. Some of them are quite mature, some are very profitable. And in time, we will get exits and generate cash and be, we hope, a self-sustaining model.
But you also have an £800,000 licensing deal with Sheffield's Medical Physics. Is this going to boost cash flow, become a revenue, significant revenue stream, or is this a one-off?
Well, that particular deal was actually a one-off. It was an interesting license deal for one piece of software, which we licensed for £800,000. That particular one was a one-off, but then there's new disclosures coming all the time. So this year, again, we're working on at least one that's not quite as big as that, but in the hundreds of thousands. So we are expecting the income from the licensing side to grow. And our objective, and it will take another couple of years, is to extinguish the remaining overhead. So generate enough license income, but there's really no net overhead cost. That's what we want to achieve.
Okay, and in terms of results, pre-tax losses in October cut to just 1.6 million. But if you take out the spin-out costs and the amortization, you're actually making a profit of 2.5 million.
Yeah.
The CFO, I hope he's talked to you about this, says you're going to make a profit this year. I mean, is that the aim, profitability this year?
Yeah, I think that's fair. I think you have to be a little bit careful, but that is the objective, absolutely right. And it may sound like funny money, perhaps, but our P&L is interesting in that the actual only cost is that net operating cost I've talked about. The rest is an amortization charge, which relates to the shares we issued to the university initially when we did our deals. It's not a cash item. And then our share of these subsidiaries. We own so many companies, so many we own more than 50%. Those ones you actually consolidate into your own results. So it's not our money going through the P&L, it's the money of all these separate companies. Right. So you've got about 1.8 million of that. So certainly when you eliminate that, we already are generating a positive return.
So what's the message to investors then? Why invest in Fusion IP rather than wait for the spin-off companies?
Yeah, well, the reason for that is you probably struggle to get access to the spin-out companies, quite frankly. Don't get me wrong, if anybody wants to contact us and invest in our companies, we'll talk to them. But it's much more tricky investing in early stage companies. This is portfolio play to some extent. You have 24, being quite honest, they won't all make it. Out of that 24, probably a third will probably never make it. Mm. And a third may only break even, get return on what you've invested, but a third will make good money. So it's probably, in terms of public markets, much wiser to be investing in us direct and diversifying your risk than trying to choose any one of our investments.
Okay, and speaking of which then, with the outlook, which portfolio companies do you think will have the biggest effect on your valuation in the next 12 months? I mean, is it the spin-off candidates like Simsip and Magnomatics, or is it some of the ones with news recently, Metaphor and Diurnal, for example?
There's a little bit of both. I think there is a kind of 8 to 10 particularly hot ones, and you've named a number of those. Simsip is a great business. That keeps increasing. I think its profits have gone from 1.2 last year to 1.7 year, just gone, and it'll keep growing. Very good business. Magnomatics, a very exciting business. Got some really revolutionary technology in magnetic gears. I think that's potential to be very valuable. Phase Focus, another particular favourite, which is lensless microscopy. It's microscopes, it doesn't use lenses. Getting some remarkable results there. So those sort of names, Diurnal again, that should finish its phase two clinical trials by mid-2012, at which point it's already got orphan drug, what they call orphan drug for a particular indication, which should be relatively valuable as well. So there's a group of those names that I think could all add value.
Okay, interesting times ahead. David Baynes, thanks very much indeed for joining us today.
You're welcome.
This film is for educational and leisure purposes only. Proactive Investors does not provide investment advice. The company is a publisher and is not registered with or authorized by the Financial Services Authority. Please refer to the full terms and conditions on the Proactive Investors website.